You are arriving there with speed in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'd like us to know, in the kingdom, there are no accidents. Miracles are no accidents. They are the deliberate acts of God. That brother testified, he has been detained for 32 days. For an offense he knew nothing about. But inside the cell, he began to engage Matthew 6:33. Say with me, he began to engage Matthew 6:33. You better say it very well right now. Those who are engaging are saying it better right now. Those who are engaging Matthew 6:33 are joining those who are engaging to say it better right now. And suddenly, a friend brought the picture of one of them and gave it to the wife. And the wife was to travel to Bayelsa to go and visit him in the cell. Can you imagine that? And the person mysteriously entered the same bus. Say me the same bus. Is that accident? Miracles are no accidents. And she was able to identify the person. Now this picture, this is the person. Okay, she kept quiet. And ensured they got to a police checkpoint. And say, I want to go to the toilet. They allowed that. I said, police, there's a customer for you there. Praise the Lord. And from that one, it was released. For everyone who is engaging in this operation, go forward. No matter how difficult your situation is, God is finally going to step in on your favor. Amen. If you are there, shout a stronger yet, amen. Amen. That brother said, I took the mantle and I began to tell her. And somebody who has not slept comfortably for 2 years. Say, I slept 6 hours non-stop. I slept like a baby. By that testimony, anyone having challenged with sleeplessness, that testimony is already pregnant for you. Amen. Your delivery of that testimony is now. Amen. If you are going to share that order of testimony, shout a stronger yet, amen. Amen. We had a testimony, somebody joined the church June 2013. He said, I was a burden to everyone around. To give an offering of 5 naira was a problem. He said, and when I came to the church, I was hearing them speak some dangerous languages. I cannot be sick. I cannot be poor. He said, these people, are we on the same planet? He said, but I began to follow them. I joined them. Then gradually, he said, now I am as sound as stone. No more health concern. He said, now I have a job that they are paying me in dollars. Is it dollars or dollars? How do you pronounce it? How do you pronounce it? Praise God. He said, now I tithe in 6 figures. That testimony is pregnant for somebody already. So it does not matter your level today. Your story is changing for the better. And God has given us a master key to exploits, a master key to a life of color in our teaching series that we have been looking at right from the beginning of the month, the master key to a world of exploits. Understanding the master key to a world of exploits. So you mean understanding the master key to a world of exploits. You better say it and mean it very well right now. So we are looking at the last part today. We have started at 5A, first service, 5B, second service, and in this service we are looking at part 5C. We have said it before that your love for God is the platform to experience a life of exploits. A life where you become an amazing wonder among men. A life that shines. A life that is enviable. A life that even angels will be spying out on you. A life in which all your pursuits, you are distinguished. A life of no stress and no strain. That's your new realm from now. And we have looked at several people, even this morning, we look at the life of a man called Apostle Paul. Say me, Apostle Paul. A tireless lover of God. Because of his love for God, he became the chiefest of the apostles. That is, when they are counting apostles, before you count number two, you must have counted Apostle Paul. He never started like that. In fact, the Bible says he was less than the least of the saints. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 8. Less than the least of the saints. That means the least of the believer was higher than Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul was a certified area boy. Unto me, who I am less than the least of all saints, there was a grace released to him, favor released to him, and from that point, he became the chiefest of the apostles. He became the most prominent apostle. Say, made the most prominent. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 11. He said, "For in nothing am I behind the very chiefest of apostles." He came last. But by reason of his die-hard love for God, he overtook everyone and became the foremost one. So if you are a believer and you love God, you may join this church last month or join this church this month of October, and you subscribe to a lifestyle of making God first in all your considerations. A lifestyle of loving what God loves. A lifestyle of loving the house of God, of loving the people of God. A lifestyle of serving God as a priority lifestyle. Your testimony will be sweeter than that of Apostle Paul. Those who are there are shouting a stronger amen. Amen. Apostle Paul, by reason of his love for God, became a god on the heart. He became what? You know, in Acts chapter 14, verse 11, they said the gods have come down to us in the likeness of. Because of his love relationship with God, he began to manifest divinity in his humanity. Because he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God dwelleth in him. And that's the purpose of our entire teachings this month of October. To get everyone connected to this mystery of love. Therefore, our love for God to begin to grow. For our love for God, for every one of us to be rooted and grounded in the love of God. When we get to that point, when our love for God is perfected, the Bible says we are going to be filled with all the fullness of God. Say me, all the fullness of God. If you are there, say it better right now. That means as we grow in our love walk, our divinity content begins to increase. The nature of God inside of us begins to increase. And as our love is perfected, only what can stop God can stop you. You cannot be filled with God and be oppressed by devils. In fact, my definition is this. If you are under satanic oppression, it's an indication that you don't love God sufficiently. Is somebody still there? If when you are sleeping,
witches and wizards are pressing you, is an indication that you are empty of the love of God. The scriptures cannot be broken, no matter the experience of man. You cannot have God on your inside, and witches and wizards are oppressing you. So, the cure to satanic harassment is to increase the divine nature of love inside of us. Intensify your engagement and demonstration of your love for God. And let me watch which devil or which wizard can oppress you. You see, people don't know what they need. God is all you need to have all your needs met. What do you need? You can't have God and have needs. You can't have the baker with you and you're looking for bread. A pipe that is carrying water cannot be looking for water. And every good thing of life is with God. Is with who? When you get at God, every good thing that God has is with you. And God is love. So you can't be in love with that God and lack the good things of life. I pray that a fresh baptism of the spirit of love be given to everyone here today. Yes. That is the master key. Somebody shared a testimony in the course of the week. He said Matthew 6:33 is the entire Bible. That was his own conclusion. That is, if you don't know anything in the Bible, if you don't know Genesis, don't know Revelation, don't know. Some people can quote Genesis. They can quote Jeremiah. Yet, you can't see the proof in their life. But if you don't understand any Bible, but you are practicing Matthew 6:33, in a matter of time, you become a living wonder. You become a God among men. You will possess the wisdom of God. You will possess the strength of God. You will possess the favor. You will not struggle with them. That's the master key. And that's the secret of this, our church. That's the secret of this, our commission. Our commission, we don't pray for things, yet we don't lack things. We don't pray for money, yet we have abundance of money. We don't pray, God, heal me, heal me, heal me. Yet, we live in sound health. Say me, sound health. The way we talk, people should not give to us. In fact, what we expect, people beg to give to us. They say, please, please now, please give me your account. I want to just give you something. Seeking one thing and getting every other thing. The grace to be connected to this root. Somebody receive it here today. That is the master key. And you become a dominion entity when you are rooted and granted in this love. I pray that same grace will begin to work for somebody here. Very quickly, this love, when you love God also, you never fail in life. You always win. Say me, I will always win. Every lover of God will always end up at the top. Every lover of God may be challenged. A lover of God may be challenged, but it can never be defeated. Let all the forces in hell come against a lover of God. They cannot see his end. A lover of God may be challenged, but at the end, it will end up triumphant. It will end up what? 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8. It said, charity, love never what? Never fails. Joseph was challenged. Joseph, the God lover, was challenged for 13 years. At the age of 17, his brother conspired and sold him to the slavery. And for 13 years, he was suffering. As a slave, as an houseboy, but his love for God was intact. At the end of it all, by age 30, Joseph, the God lover, moved from the prison to the palace. And he reigned for 80 years. He died at the age of 110. He suffered for 17 years. And reigned for 80 years. So it doesn't matter how long you have been challenged. If you will retain and sustain your love for God, your testimony is sure. Job, the love of God was challenged. But he refused to sell off. There are many people who are surrendering because of challenges and circumstances of life. The challenges of life is pushing them to the old court. It's pushing them to courts. It's pushing them to herbalist houses. They are taking permanent decisions in a temporary situation. But Job stayed with God. And in Job chapter 42, I read verse 11, 12, and 16. He said, and God blessed the latter end of Job more than the beginning of Job. Job chapter 42, you'll find that story there. The Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than his beginning. The end of a God lover is always better. I don't know what you have seen before. Your end will be better than where you are today. No matter what you have tasted in glory, in favor, in prosperity before, greater ones are coming your way from now. If you look at verse 16, the Bible says, Job lived for 140 years more. And 140 years, and saw his sons, and his sons' sons, even to the fourth generation. Every God lover enjoys longevity. Everyone receiving this baptism today, nothing will succeed to cut short your life. It doesn't matter your age now. You'll be alive to see your grandchildren occupying thrones in your lifetime. I said in your lifetime, your grandchildren will be occupying thrones. Those who are receiving it are shouting a strong amen. Some people, because they say they are not married, they are not saying a good amen. I am saying, even though you are single now, you'll be married. Amen. And you will have children. Amen. And your children will have children. Amen. And your children's children will have children. Amen. And you will still be alive to be present when they are alive. Amen. Those who are receiving it are shouting the stronger yet, amen. Amen. The love of God may be challenged, but it will end up triumphant. Now, what are the biblical proofs of love? If you love God, you will flow in revelation. You will flow in revelation. You will enjoy divine secrets. Psalm 25, verse 9. It said, the secrets of God are with them that fear him. That is in the New Testament, Old Testament, sorry. Now, the word fear of God in the Old Testament is those who love God. The fear of God is not that they are afraid of God. They are in love with God. The secrets of God are with the lovers of God. John chapter 15, verse 15. He said, I have called you friends because I have made known unto you all things. Say, I mean all things. And the basis for friendship is love. Love is the basis for friendship. So when you are a lover of God, you become a friend of God. And God can confide and show you secrets. Your secrets are not with every Dick and Harry in the church or in town. Your secrets are only with your lovers. Is somebody still there? Now, some of you are here in the service this morning. Your neighbor, the person sharing the next flat to you in your house, may have assumed you have traveled to Benin. But your friend in Maduguri, before you left the house, excuse me, I am going to church in Mother Resources today. One of my friends is doing child education. In fact, I've come to that church. I think I will remain in that church from now. I thought I'm hearing amen. Now, your next door neighbor doesn't know where you have gone to. But your friend in Maduguri, because of their love relationship, say me love relationship, he will tell you of his minute, detailed movements. Your secrets are with your lovers. And it is the secrets of God that make stars of men. What makes stars of men?
when God shows you a secret, that secret will reveal you to your world. God reveals secret to Joseph. A king had a dream and he couldn't know the interpretation. But the interpretation of that dream was revealed to Joseph, the God lover. That was what brought Joseph from the prison to the palace. God revealed secret to Daniel. Daniel chapter 2 verse 17 and 19. He said, then was the secret revealed to Daniel in a night vision. Verse 19. It was the revelation of that secret that made Daniel to become a celebrity in a strange land. A king had a dream and forgot his dream. Maybe he had too much starch and banga that day. And forgot the dream. And said, well, if nobody tells me this dream and the interpretation, all the wise men are dead. And the wise men, the occultic powers, the herbalists, the astrologers of those days, they said, king, the thing you are requesting from us, nobody can know this secret. No human being can accept this secret. Because even if you are sleeping with your wife on the bed and your wife dreamt, will you know the dream? Will you know? No access. Daniel came and said, king, the thing you are asking for, don't worry, give me time. I am a lover of God. God has access to everything. God knows everything. My lover will reveal it to me when I go and meet him. So in the night, God, with whom Daniel was in love, revealed the secret to him. Hear this. In this end time, we shall be reigning by divine secrets. Amen. You will know things that your competitors can only be dreaming about. Amen. I thought I'm hearing a stronger amen. Amen. In business, in career, God will be releasing divine ideas, inspiration, that will bring about creativity of new things, inventions. But it will only be for his lovers. There was a man called David, the man after the heart of God. In Acts chapter 2, verse 30 and verse 31. He said, David, being a prophet, David was not a prophet, but by reason of his love for God, he became a prophet. God was confiding in him. He said, knowing afar off, David was have access to things that will happen hundreds of years after he has gone. David could picture the coming of Christ. Verse 30, verse 31. He said, knowing from afar. Therefore, being a prophet and knowing that God has sworn with an oath that of the fruit of his loins, that Jesus will come through him. He's seen this before. Say me, seen this before. I'm not hearing somebody right now. He saw far ahead of others. So when I see a believer who is looking for a professional prophet to see a vision for him, to interpret vision for him, that means he has no love for God. He has no what? If you have a love for God, God your father will reveal secret to you. You won't need another man to go and consult. Is somebody still there? You are reporting yourself to God. God will see me. I don't love you, even though you are my father, but I don't love you. I hate you. So I want to go and meet others to help me see because I am blind and deaf. Those people are not in this church. I thought I'm hearing a stronger amen. Job had access to divine secrets. Job 29 verse 4 to 6 said, then were the secrets of God upon my tabernacle. It was the secret of God that made Job to become the greatest businessman. Every businessman, you need that secret to be on top in your field. Anything you are doing, either you are a tailor, a teacher, a pastor, You need certain secrets. They call them trade secrets. They are the things that make the difference between you and others. If you know what others don't know, you will lead them. But God only reveals them to his lovers. Say me, I love God. Say me, I receive grace to love God. Remember, love of God is not in words. If you know you love God, you will love what God loves. God loves the salvation of souls. You must be about your father's business. You don't say, God, that I am too busy. You don't have a heart for God. That's why you are saying you are too busy. What time? There's time for anything you have love for. Am I communicating? Anything you love, you always have what? You have time for it. Let me tell your neighbor. Let me tell your neighbor. My neighbor. Anything you love, you always have time for it. Do you have time for God? That's the proof. Do you have time to win souls? That's the proof. May you receive a heart after God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, also, if you love God, you will enjoy supernatural favor. You will enjoy what? I'm not hearing somebody there at all. The love for God is a platform for the flow of favor. Psalms 102, verse 13 to 15. It said, thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion. For the time to favor her, yeah, the set time is come. For thy servant take pleasure in her stones and favor the dust thereof. It says, so the heathen shall fear the name of the Lord, and all the kings of the earth thy glory. That is, if you love God, you will serve him. If you love God, what will you do? If you are not serving him, what does that mean? Ask your neighbor, are you serving God? Okay, answer your neighbor now. Is it with mouth or by action? Okay, tell your neighbor which action? Oh yeah, answer your neighbor now. Praise God. He said, if you serve me, I will bless your bread and your water. That's favor. Say me favor. If you serve me, I will take sickness away from your body. Say me favor. If you serve me, the numbers of your days you will fulfill. Say me favor. If you serve me, none shall be buried in your land. Say me favor. When you love God, you will serve him. And when you serve him, he will favor you. What am I saying, people of God? As we begin to talk about favor right now, the favor of God is not free. The favor of God is not what? It's not free. People think favor is unmerited. People say grace is unmerited favor. It's far from it. The only favor that is free is a favor for salvation. Favor for what? Titus chapter 2 verse 11. It said, the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men. The favor of God, grace means favor, that brings salvation, appeared to all men. That one is very free. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6. It said, we are saved by grace through faith. That is free. You don't pay any price to be saved. When you are saved, you become a candidate. You are enlisted as a candidate of God's favor. It's like you are matriculated into the school of favor. Matriculation and graduation, are they the same thing? Can you imagine a student now who did matriculation and started going about, hey, I'm matriculated, I'm not a graduate. Are they the same thing? Yeah. It's the beginning. It's just that you now have the right to write the exam of that school. Am I correct? So, if you are just celebrating your matriculation, when they bring out a test, you are not writing. You are just doing jam bites all over the place. You are playing all over. And by the time the result come out and you know you fail, you just say rusticated. So, matriculation is not the same thing as graduation. So, there is
What redemption does is to bring us as a candidate to be favored. Psalm chapter 5, verse 12. It said, the Lord will bless the righteous with favor. And with favor, he will compass him like a shield. So many people are frustrated because they are waiting for divine favor, doing nothing. If you are waiting, doing nothing, expecting something, the person will end up in frustration. There is what you must do to enjoy favor. But before I get to that, what is in favor? Ask your neighbor, what is in favor? I'm not hearing somebody there. Supernatural breakthroughs is in favor. Supernatural what? Supernatural breakthroughs is in favor. Because favor will make you to be loved and preferred. Favor will make you to be preferred above others. Favor will make others to like you. They will prefer you above others who are even more qualified than you. Is somebody still there? In 1 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 4, he said, how be it? The Lord God of Israel chose me before the house of my father to be king over Israel forever. The last part, and among the sons of my father, he liked me to make me king. I like that one. Favor will make others to like you. Others are equally qualified. They are even better qualified. But favor will say, in spite of their equal qualifications, I prefer you. Those who are receiving are something stronger, amen. Amen. David was not there when they were looking for king. He was in the bush. But because of God's favor upon him, the prophet said, we are not going to sit down until that young boy come here. So it's not by age. It's by God's favor. Say, may God's favor. That is, you are competing with others for certain things, either jobs or contracts or promotion. Even those others are even more qualified than you. They say, no, we just like you. We don't know what it is. I just like you. I just like you. I like your nose. I like your name. I like your dressing. After this service today, people will just like something about you. Those who are receiving it are shouting a stronger amen. For instance, when it comes to marriage, what you need is favor. What you need is what? Because inside favor is miracle marriage. He that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and has obtained what? Favor of the Lord. Esther obtained favor. He said when she stood before the king, she obtained favor in the sight of all. Say, may the sight of all. I'm not hearing somebody right now. Esther chapter 2, verse 15. Everyone that looked at her liked her. Somebody's leaving this service as a new Esther. If you are down, shout a stronger amen. Amen. It was like there was an invisible garment of favor. That garment I release upon somebody here today. Amen. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, receive the garment of favor. Amen. Upon your business, receive the garment of favor. Amen. Upon your certificate, receive the garment of favor. Amen. Upon your children, receive the garment of favor. When the garment of favor is upon you, you are never a victim of rejection. You are never a victim of misfortune. The lines will be falling to you in pleasant places. That becomes your new story. In the name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible says, Esther, a crown was placed upon her head. In verse 17, it said, and a royal crown was placed upon her head, and she was made a queen instead of Vashti. If you know that story, they forgot about the background of Esther. Esther was a foreigner. Esther was a stranger. Esther was a slave. But when favor is speaking for you,
Your background, your inadequacies, your shortcomings, they are relegated to the background. That order of favor is landing upon somebody here right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. What is favor? What is inside of favor? Favor delivers mercy. Favor delivers what? In Isaiah chapter 60, verse 10. Isaiah 60, verse 10. He said, the last part, but in my favor have I had what? Mercy, mercy. Mercy. Shout with me, mercy. You better shout it better right now.
Mercy.
What is mercy? You have done something and you deserve punishment. But when mercy is answering, he said, well, even though he has done wrong, let us overlook his errors. Let us allow him to go free. When you are enjoying favor by mercy, in your place of work, the things others do and they sack them, you will do them and they will promote you. Those who are receiving it, I shout a stronger amen.
Yeah.
He said, in my favor. I tell you, many of us are where we are today by God's favor. By the grace of God, I am not where I am because I can preach the best. I am not where I am because I have joined the ministry for long. I don't know, have any connection. But favor. Say me favor.
Favor.
In ministry, in life, in every area. Say me favor.
Favor.
I enjoy things that my effort cannot bring. I enjoy honor from above, from peers, from subordinates, without asking. Shout with me, favor.
Favor.
As received from our fathers in the faith. As they are enjoying, many of us, we are enjoying that order of favor you are receiving today.
Yeah.
What more is in favor? Favor terminates emptiness. Exodus 3:21. He said, I will give these people favor and they shall not go empty. What is emptiness? It talks about frustration. It talks about wasted efforts. You can labor, you can work hard, but if you are not favored, the person will be an hustler for life, a struggler for life. You know what Apostle Paul said? 1 Corinthians 15 verse 10. He said, I am what I am by the grace of God. I am what I am by the favor of God. He said, nevertheless, even though I labor more than them all. 15 verse 10, please. I labored more than them all. But it was the favor factor that made me to stand out far above others. So no matter your input, no matter your efforts, if favor is not there, it will amount to emptiness. Israel labored for 430 years. They had nothing to show. But one day of God's favor, all the arrears of 430 years, they got it in one day. They became carriers of gold. Who dashed monkey banana? Where will slaves get gold? They were carrying luggages of gold when they were leaving Egypt. By God's favor. I don't know your position today. I don't know what wants to create emptiness around your life. By the favor today, that emptiness is terminated forever.
Yeah.
Very quickly, we are going out of time. What else is in favor? Favor turns your mourning into dancing. Wherever you are crying or weeping, favor converts mourning, weeping, crying, sorrow into dancing, celebration, and jubilation. Psalm chapter 30, from verse 5 and verse 11. It said, thou hast turned my mourning into what? into dancing. If you look at verse 5, it said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes when? And it is the favor of God that brings your morning of joy. It's the favor of God that makes the night of weeping to go away. By the impartation of favor today, somebody's night season is finally over right now. Somebody's morning of celebration is arriving right now. If you are there, shout a stronger amen. What more is in favor? Favor makes you a high flyer. Psalm chapter 30 verse 7. He said, by thy favor, thou hast caused my mountains to stand strong. You stand out. You stand out. When you are favored, you stand out. From today, by the baptism of favor you are receiving here today, you will not be lost in the crowd again. Amen. If you are there, shout a stronger yet, amen. Amen. But very quickly, what are the channels of favor? Say me, channels of favor. Say it louder right now. Number one, we have said it, redemption channel. Say me, redemption channel. The loudest you can. Psalm chapter 5, verse 12. If you are born again, you become a candidate for favor. Number two, channel of favor is kingdom addiction channel. Say me, kingdom addiction channel. Say it better right now. Kingdom addiction, particularly the one for soul winning. John chapter 15 and verse 16. He said, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, that you go forth and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit may remain. Is that okay? And that whatsoever, say me whatsoever. Whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name, say me favor. Say it better right now. That is, by reason of your involvement in bringing fruits to God, bringing souls to God, God is saying, I will give you a blank check of favor. Somebody is going home with that blank check today. So when you make it your lifestyle, that no Sunday will come and you will not think of at least one soul. I've been so busy because of the week, but yesterday I told myself, I must not appear on any Sunday without new souls coming through me. So I went out on Saturday, yesterday. And one of the people that I invited, I saw him coming to give his life to Christ in the first service. Now, there are others, some of them are even in this service right now. That is how favor comes. Favor is not free. When you favor God, God favors you. Every man is the initiator of divine favor in his life. You can't be waiting for God to favor you. God will ask you, are you favoring my kingdom? Are you doing things that bring joy to my heart? God favored that brother that was held in cell for 32 days because he was favoring his kingdom. Favoring his kingdom. The grace to favor the kingdom. May you receive it today. And of course, you know, when God favors you, let no man attempt to disfavor you, because God will deal with them. Because when you favor the kingdom, bringing souls, he said, they that honor me, I will do what? Anyone that wants to dishonor the one that is under the favor of God, God will use their nose to rub the ground. Will use their nose to do what? Will rub the ground. Say, you are trying to mess up somebody I am honoring. When you see a man being favored and honored by God, be afraid of him. That's the new you. I said, that's the new you. If you will engage in praying for souls, if you will engage in seeing to it that they came. Somebody shared a testimony in the second service. He said one of our deacons here met him outside, brought him to the church, prayed outside, was mentoring him. Until now, the husband left the woman. Now, the husband has come back now. Everything is fine now. You hear the other man here. I like that testimony. He said somebody invited him to this church. He said he now got a job. He said the salary will cause high blood pressure. Ah, that's a dangerous one. He said, because of over-happiness. Say me, over-happiness. Now, he joined this church last year. You can see the uniform. That means he's a part of traffic servant. He was serving God in traffic. Serving God in winning souls. So, God has to organize his favor. Somebody's favor, God will organize it for you in November. If you would dare engage in bringing souls to church next Sunday, as the Lord liveth, in the next 14 days, your own favor is landing in your hand. How many will strive to bring a new soul to church next Sunday? Let me see your hand. You want to believe God for at least one new soul? Let me see your hand. Say with me, Lord Jesus, help me next Sunday, at least one new soul must follow me to this place. I receive that grace. And by that grace, I see my favor landing. It is not. Let somebody shout glory. Number four, very quickly, let's move very fast. I don't have all the time. If you want to be favored, trust God. Say me the trust channel. I'm not hearing somebody right now. Say me the trust channel. Louder, you can. The trust channel. In Jeremiah 17, verse 5, it said, cursed be that man that trusted a man and maketh flesh his arm, whose heart departed from the law. It shall be like they eat in the desert, and shall not see when good is coming, but shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness, in a salt land, and not inhabited. What am I saying? Never have an alternative to God. Never have what? Anything you are using apart from God for favor is the major reason why God will turn his back on you. God is too big to be a subcontractor of any man's life. It's either you give your life wholly to him to manage for you. He will not accept some part. Some people Sunday morning, they come to church. In the night, they go to the herbalist. They go to occultic meeting. They go to court meetings. That is a major reason why God will turn his back on many people. I don't know what your mother has given you for favor. I remember somebody told me last year, they said the mother took her to somewhere. I said she must marry. They gave her something to rub on her lips, on her face, that when she sees a man that she likes, she just wink her face several times, the man will like her. And she has been trying that. Nothing has worked. Psalm 16 verse 4. He said, the sorrows of them that seek after other gods shall do what? Shall multiply. Whatever favor God cannot give you, let no man attempt to do it. That should be your position. When you stick with God, God will come through for you. God will come through for somebody here. Amen. Number three or number what? Number four. Well, just be writing whatever number you want to write. The meekness channel. Say me the meekness channel. I'm not hearing somebody right now. The loudest you can right now. He said, God giveth grace to the meek. He giveth what? He said, but the proud, he will know them from where? From afar. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5. James chapter 4, verse 6. He giveth more grace. The word grace talks about favor. So, the meeker you are, the more favor you enjoy. And grace or favor is what makes great. Nobody ever experienced any form of greatness without meekness. He said, the meek shall inherit the heart. The heart will be in the pocket. The wealth of the heart will be in the pocket of the meek. Because God will be favoring them. Who is the meek? Whatever God is saying to you from his word, do it. God is saying, win soul. If you are meek, what will you do? Win soul, then God will favor you. Number what now? Number five. To be favored, keep company with the favored. Keep company with what? The favored. A favored company will rub off on you. Proverbs 13 verse 20, he that walks with the wise shall be wise, a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Genesis 13 verse 5, he said, and Lot also, Say me Lot also. Say better, Lot also. Which went with Abraham. Lot also, Genesis 13 verse 5. Which went with Abraham. Because he was associating and keeping company with Abraham. The favor grace, the favor anointing upon Abraham rubbed off on Lot. He said, when Saul came into the midst of prophets, he began to do what? If a man is walking in the company of a cursed person, what will happen to the person? Everyone that traveled with Jonah, who was under a curse, they were to drown with Jonah. May you not travel with a cursed person.
Amen.
May you not be in the same boat with a cursed person.
Amen.
May you be in the same boat with a blessed person.
Amen.
May you be in the same boat with a favored person.
Amen.
I want to submit humbly that this church, that this our commission, is a favored spiritual family. Say me, a favored spiritual family. Where everything works for us. Say me everything. Spiritual things. Financial things. Family things. Health things. Everything is working. When you see his servant, Bishop David, and when you see many of us, and many people in this church who are following, who are connected, everything is working in their favor. There's somebody on your row. Everything is working for them. Many people are joining that list. That spiritually, they are on top. Materially, they are on top. In their health, they are on top. Satan cannot dare them. Why? They are keeping company with a favored body. A favored body. A favored body. So this commission is like a New Testament Abraham. That everyone that joins it and connect with the happiness in the commission, they are blessed with the same favor that the commission enjoys. So don't just be coming to this church as a visitor. Be a partaker. Say me a partaker. Be a stakeholder. Don't be a bent warmer. Connect your heart by your actions to the happiness in this place. Then the favor anointing will be rubbing off on you. Hear this. This commission, we have been flying plane since 1996. Since when? And we have changed many, several. Brand new. Some flew plane once. After some time, they can't maintain again. But we are maintaining plane as if we are maintaining a motorcycle. Running universities without stress. Frontline universities. Having multi-billion projects going on simultaneously in many locations without begging for money. We have never raised money as a prayer point once. Look at Bishop Edeko. Everything is working. Children are doing excellently. That can only be God. You may teach your children, but can you force them to do okay? You can't. There are many great people, their children are wayward. But when you are a lover of God and you are connected to the happiness here, whatever that man represents, what happened to you, not one of your children shall be a concern.
Amen.
In a short while, you'll be connecting that grace.
Amen.
Say me, I'll be connecting that grace. Number what now? Let me give us one more as I close. That's why I like church service. Number what now? The prophetic channel. Say me, the prophetic channel. I'm not hearing somebody there. Exodus chapter 12. Verse 35 and 36. He said, God gave them favor because the people did what Moses told them to do. Verse 36. And the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians. Moses told them, and they responded to the instruction of Moses. Go back to that verse 35, please. And the children of Israel did according to what? The word of Moses. He said, if you shall hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord thy God, which I command thee today, is the commandment of God. But I, Moses, I am the instrument through which those instructions are being passed across. He said, if you will follow these instructions, all these blessings, all this favor shall begin to follow you. The prophetic connection to favor. As you obey prophetic instructions, expect favor. Because inside that obedience, there are prophetic blessings. So for everyone who has been obeying scriptural prophetic instructions in this place, welcome to your season of favor. Amen. If you are there, shout a stronger yet, amen.
Amen.
In Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 1 and verse 33, it said, this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel. And in verse 23, he began to list the blessings. He said, and of Naphtali, oh Naphtali, be satisfied with what? So I stand in the place of Moses under this great commission that today, be satisfied with favor.
Amen.
That by this favor impartation, possess the west.
Amen.
Possess the east.
Amen.
Possess every good thing of life.
Amen.
I said, by this impartation of favor today, everywhere you go, you'll be magnetizing goodness and mercy.
Amen.
If you are receiving that, shout a stronger amen.
Amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus right now. Hallelujah. Now, before the final impartation, you are in this service, you are not born again. The first thing is, you need to give your life to Christ. Until you give your life to Christ, life will be full of misfortune, crisis. But when you give your life to Christ, you become a candidate of favor. You have a platform for God to favor you. Wherever you are in this service, you are not born again yet. Or you are born again and the connection between you and God has been cut off. You have an opportunity to either surrender your life fresh or you rededicate your life to God. Wherever you are, I would like those people right now, I know there are many of them, who want to give their life to Christ. They are tired of struggles. They are tired of misfortune. They want a new name. They want a new story. Wherever you are, stand to your feet right now. God bless you. God bless you. Stand to your feet right now. You want to give your life to Christ? You need to surrender. God bless. They are coming up. They are standing up. I thought somebody is clapping for them. God bless you. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Carry your bags. Carry your Bible. Whatever you came to church with, begin to find your way here right now. Begin to find your way here. I thought somebody is clapping for them. They are coming. God does not condemn sinners. God only condemns hypocrites. You know you are not saved. If you are not saved by Christ, you are not safe in life. Wherever you are, stand to your feet, carry your bags, carry your Bible, and come this way. They are coming. They are coming. Hallelujah. After this, right now, we have the impartation. After that, we have the general thanksgiving session. In the name of you. They are still coming. I thought somebody is still clapping. They're coming. While they are still coming, be reminded, our week of spiritual emphasis in this week, we are